On November 20th, 2018, the opposition St. Lucia Labor Party filed a motion of no confidence in Prime Minister Alan Chastney, citing, among other things, abuse of public office, unsustainable fiscal deficits, squandering of the state's financial resources, thus eroding public confidence in the Prime Minister's ability to govern the country. Now the opposition is taking issue with the recently imposed state of emergency, calling it abusive and indicative of blatant disregard for the rights of citizens. To this end, the Labour Party is planning to write the police, seeking permission to hold a massive rally during the first week in October to express its disapproval of what it calls the vindictive policies of the United Workers' Party government.
We'll be writing to the police to seek permission to hold a peaceful protest during the first week of October. We urge all St. Lucians to prepare to participate.
It is left to be seen whether the police will grant permission for the march, considering that the Black Lives Matter event to protest black oppression went ahead without permission from the police commissioner's office, and the arrest of prominent media personality Christopher Hunt, accused of inciting an illegal public march in violation of the Public Order Act. The request is also coming at a time when social distancing is still a major part of health and safety protocols against the deadly coronavirus pandemic. That said, the opposition, if elected into office at the next general elections, has promised to repeal laws that, in its opinion, violate human rights.
One of the priorities of the St. Lucia Labour Party when it forms the next government will be to review, with the aim of correcting and or repealing, all laws on our books which facilitate government pursuing actions and policies that violate the democratic rights of the citizens of this country.
The opposition leader made the announcement at Monday's press conference. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.